Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your midday news brief. As of February 23, 2020, the World Health Organization reported a total of 78,811 confirmed cases of COVID-19 from China, with 2,445 deaths. There are now 1,769 confirmed cases in 28 countries outside of China. There have been 17 deaths outside of China, and the cases on cruise ship lining in Japan has now gone to 634, with 2 deaths. Dr. Sharon Belmer-George, Chief Medical Officer, stated that there are no confirmed cases of the coronavirus disease in St. Lucia or the Caribbean region. The Department of Health and Wellness advises the public to continue practicing the standard recommendations to prevent the spread of respiratory infection. These include regular hand washing of soap and water or alcohol-based hand sanitizer, new disposable tissues when coughing and sneezing, and to avoid close contact with anyone showing symptoms of respiratory illness such as coughing and sneezing. Dr. Belmer-George noted that the Department of Health and Wellness will continue informing the public of any updates. The Ministry of Education continues to develop the love for science among students through the National School Science Quiz. This year, each of the 8 districts were represented by a primary and secondary school. The 2-day quiz tested the students' knowledge of science facts. The Pierrot Combined School and the St. Joseph's Convent emerged as the winners of the National School Science Quiz. Curriculum Officer for Natural Sciences, Gianetti George, noted that the National Science Quiz was held under the theme Science and Technology, Pillars of Entrepreneurship and Innovation. The National Science Quiz was held at the John Odlum Secondary School in Marigot from Wednesday, February 12th to Thursday, February 13th, 2020. Prime Minister of St. Lucia and immediate past chairman of CARICOM, Honorable Alan Chastney, highlighted a number of issues that continue to be a priority for the community. These include the CARICOM single market and economy, to which the Prime Minister indicated that CARICOM should arrive at some decision so as to demonstrate to the people across the region its determination to make the integration process work for them. With the United Kingdom leaving the European Union at the end of this year, CARICOM has been in ongoing discussions with the UK on an agreement that would govern trade between the Caribbean region post-Brexit and replicate the effects of the CARIFORUM European Union Economic Partnership Agreement, EPA. Prime Minister Chastney explained that this will ensure continuity in the preferential trading relationship and avoid disruption in preferential trade between the CARIFORUM states and the United Kingdom. This has been your midday news brief. Thank you for watching.